Hello, I'm Elizabeth Mannin. It's now May 8th, or as we at SLOCA know it to be, World Ovarian Cancer Day. We've all developed our own ways to cope with COVID-19. Some of us watch the news incessantly. Some of us, not at all. Some have decided to let their hair grow out, and some have taken matters into their own hands. There's despair everywhere you look, and equal amounts of hope and joy too, it seems. One thing is for certain, women are still being diagnosed with ovarian cancer, and SLOCA still has their backs, the backs of those women and their caregivers and families. To do that, we've had to get creative this year. No need to spring for a new teal dress, get your nails or hair done, or pop for a babysitter. You can simply grab the beverage of your choice and support SLOCA from the comfort of your couch in the outfit of your choice. And you have 3 days to do it. St. Louis, these are your sisters and your mothers and your wives and your co-workers and community members that you are supporting. Area companies and individuals have stepped up to donate some unique and flat-out fun getaways, goods and services on which you can bid. How, do you ask? It's pretty simple. Visit sloca.org/gala, where you will be able to create your Ready Set Auction account. You have until this Sunday night at midnight to bid on your favorite items. COVID-19 has turned everything upside down for all of us. An abrupt change from a gala to an online event doesn't just happen. It takes the support, courage, and passion of people and corporations that care about the cause and the women of our community. A tremendous thank you goes to our presenting sponsor, Myriad Genetic Laboratories. Myriad has provided SLOCA financial support, as well as access to expert speakers and thought leaders, supporting our efforts to help raise awareness of the signs and symptoms of ovarian cancer in our community. Our attitude of gratitude extends to all of our corporate and foundation sponsors who have underwritten our online auction this weekend. And as we know, nothing happens without people power. Our biggest ovarian advocates, without a doubt, are our co-chairs, Randall N. Vasel and Lisa Cannon Bearden. They embody the spirit set forth by our founders who started around a kitchen table in 2002. Like you, I've had numerous discussions about COVID with family and friends. Some are scared. Some have experienced hellish situations like the death of a loved one to whom they could not properly mourn or say goodbye. Some have comorbidities that put them at high risk and they live in fear and stress. For women that live with ovarian cancer, these are not new feelings at all. Loneliness, isolation, fear, helplessness, the unknown are part of every day, from diagnosis on. However, a solid support system, a sisterhood, hope for a future cure, someone to call who's been there, they create feelings of strength and hope and resilience, feelings of a future. Over the next 3 days, you will have a chance to help create that future. See you online.